Hi everyone, this is Balázs from RacingBrick. You haven't seen a laser engraver on this channel for quite a while, and that wasn't by accident. After all my previous tests, I felt like I had shown you everything that was worth exploring when it comes to using laser technology with LEGO. But then, something changed. A company called ACMER reached out to me and asked if I'd like to try one of their latest machines, the P3 2-in-1 laser engraver. I was skeptical at first, but once they mentioned it comes with both a diode and an infrared laser module, I thought this might actually offer something new, especially for LEGO applications. Before we dive in, let me make a few things clear. This is not a product review. The machine was provided by ACMER, but they had no influence on the content. I'm simply here to share my experience with the device and the cool things I was able to do with it. So, a few weeks ago, this huge box showed up. I expected to spend about an hour assembling it and figuring out where everything goes, but I was wrong. Most of the components were actually packed neatly inside the machine itself: materials, accessories, the laser modules, goggles, air assist pump, everything was included. I just had to remove a few plastic blocks that held things in place during transport, and even that was easy with the included tools. There was one extra part to remove, which was specific to the 2-in-1 version. But overall, setup was surprisingly quick. I connected the power cables, the air assist hose, the pump and the data cable on the side, and I was basically done. The whole thing took about 10 minutes, and that includes the time I spent filming. Focusing is manual using a built-in rod that sets the distance from the material. It's not super precise, but in practice it worked well enough for what I needed. The device has a Class 1 safety certification, which means with the enclosure it's as safe to operate as a CD player. You still get safety goggles, and as always, when working with a device like this, you should prepare yourself with all possible safety precautions. For my part, I have done everything. There's a safety lock here, emergency stop button, and this is how we turn on the machine. They also sent me an air purifier, which is supposed to filter smoke and fumes. Unfortunately, it doesn't have a hose output, so I used a different setup to vent smoke outside during the tests. For software, I used Lightburn. It's a paid program I already had, and you need it for features like camera control. Calibration takes some time, you'll need some of the supplied materials for it, but once it's done it works quite well. I also received a nice test material kit with various types of materials to demonstrate the capabilities of both the 10-watt diode and the 2-watt infrared laser. There was one thing I couldn't find in the manual though: how to switch between the two laser modules. It's not complicated, but it took me a bit to figure it out. Here's the switch in case you're wondering. I did a few test engravings and cuts using their recommended settings. Everything worked smoothly. The 10-watt diode laser isn't extremely powerful, but it's more than enough for engraving and for cutting certain materials as well. But let's get to the real reason you are here, the thing you probably already saw: engraving LEGO parts. As most of you know, LEGO bricks are primarily made of ABS plastic, and that's a tricky material to work with. Melting or engraving ABS can release harmful fumes and isn't really recommended. In previous tests with diode lasers, even the lowest setting would melt the plastic, and even with good ventilation, the smell was very strong, not something I wanted to repeat. This is where the infrared laser comes in. I created a test grid using different power settings to see how it would react to ABS, and the results were actually pretty amazing. I will show the details under better lighting in the studio, but even at 30-40% power, the laser left a visible mark with almost no damage to the surface. In fact, the effect looks more like a printed pattern than an engraving. And the best part, no burning smell at all. I tested a few different LEGO colors, and white turned out especially well. I also like the results on dark bluish gray. The options are definitely promising. So now that I could engrave LEGO, I needed a proper project. I picked something with a lot of flat surfaces, the LEGO Icons 10337 Lamborghini Countach. You've probably seen the Liberty Walk upgrade of the Countach. I took some inspiration from that and decided to give this one a custom RacingBrick style livery. The actual modifications were minimal, but I did spend quite a bit of time disassembling the car, placing the panels under the laser, aligning everything carefully and running each engraving. Some parts were tricky. I had to build custom supports to hold them at the right height, while others were much easier since they were flat and removable. Time to put everything together. Some parts were removed and can be reattached now. Some sections were generic pieces I could buy separately and now I can replace them, but here is the end result and I really like it. The engravings have a great tone, not as bold as a sticker or a printed graphic, but the coverage is even and continuous with no gaps. It's a really clean finish. I could probably get something similar with a printer, but doing this on assembled sections would be much more difficult. And yes, the QR code engraved on the roof actually works. I will definitely be using that at future exhibitions. I'm really happy with how it turned out, and I'm already thinking about what to customize next. If you have any ideas for LEGO builds that would look cool with laser engraved details, let me know in the comments. And just for fun, I also tried something bigger. I created an image of our old trusty technician figure across multiple LEGO tiles and it turned out to be a sort of LEGO puzzle. The engraving took about an hour and a half and I think it looks great at this size. So, I think this machine can do some really cool things even with LEGO. I still wouldn't recommend buying it just for engraving LEGO parts, but if you are into DIY projects and looking for a new tool, this is a versatile and easy to use option. So folks, let me know what you think about this solution. Do you think it can be an alternative to stickers or prints in some scenarios? Let's talk about it in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe with notifications as more exciting LEGO videos are coming soon. See you next time, bye bye.